Hello everyone and welcome to another refreshing and technologically advanced reviews from GadMode, and today we'll be reviewing one of the most anticipated phones of the year 2017, which is the Oppo F3 Plus. So to begin with, we are sitting here at the Oppo Store in Jayanagar, third block, Bangalore, a pretty good place to check out and buy Oppo phones. And this piece was provided to us as a demo piece for review purposes from the store. And to begin with, this is one of the most latest offerings from Oppo to have a dual selfie front camera, 16 megapixel camera and 18 megapixel wide angle 120 degree shooter. And with the help of these two cameras, the users will be able to snap a classic solo shot and they are in the mood of selfie, and this is a direct competition to the Vivo's latest offering with a dual selfie front cam, which is the Vivo V5 Plus, available in the Indian market starting today with a price tag of 30,990 rupees. The Oppo F3 Plus features a huge 6-inch screen, which again makes it a phablet, and a battery capacity of 4000 mAh, which actually supports VOOC fast charging, 4GB of RAM and at 64GB of internal storage. The packaging of the F3 Plus is very much the same like all the other Oppo phone packaging, which is very much elegant and precise. Now coming to the phone, it feels very much premium to hold on, and as we know that Oppo is pretty much famous for two reasons. One is the front selfie camera, and the second one is that the looks of the Oppo are similar to that of the iPhone 6s. Now coming to the bottom of the phone, we can see the USB charging port, the speaker grills and the 3.5mm jack. Top of the phone is left pretty much empty other than the noise cancellation port. On the right, we have the power button and the dual SIM card slot. On the left, we have the volume rocker. So the edges of the phone are precisely cut, thus adding up to the build quality of the phone. On the back, we have the 16 megapixel shooter with fine 3 antenna bands that run across both the top and bottom of the phone. And again, we have this description sticker on the back of the phone, which says a lot about the SIM card slots and its hybrid quality. And on the front, we have the dual front facing cameras along with the speaker. And on the bottom of the screen, we have the home button that adds up as a fingerprint sensor. Now this is pretty much the same design that we can see in the F1S and the F1 Plus. Both are the same, almost exactly the same. Now coming to the user interface of the phone, like all other Oppo phones, this phone also runs on the Color OS. Now this is based on the Android 6.0 version, which is an outdated version considering the Google Oh, that was recently released, but again we can expect an update pretty much sooner. Now if you are talking about the user friendliness of this user interface, it is pretty much the same experience that you get while using the other Oppo devices. I mean, the icons are laid out in the most simplest manner possible like the all the other Oppo devices. The screen is bright enough and it does not disappoint you in on the outside sunlight, where you will not face any issues with screen blurring out or anything like that. Now coming to the settings, we can see that the icons are neatly laid out and all the available options are in the presentable order and format. And coming to the about phone section, we have the details of the phone, which actually show the details such as the Color OS version, which is 3.0, the Android version 6.0, the processor, which is a Qualcomm MSM8976 Pro Octa-Core 1, the RAM is a 4GB one, and the internal storage, which is shown as 64GB. Now this is a pretty good configuration when you consider the price point at which this is available. So we'll be back with an in-depth review of this phone in the second part of this video. For the time being, do give a thumbs up to this video, subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell button that is there beside the subscribe button so that you won't miss out on our updates.